Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Tamar Mizels. Today I wanted to talk about some very interesting views and quotes from Rabbi Lord Jonathan Sacks. Rabbi Sacks was an English Orthodox rabbi, but he was also a philosopher, a Torah scholar, an author. He wrote more than 25 books. He's best known for being the Chief Rabbi of the Commonwealth from 1993 till 2013. I read a few of his books and I really wanted to share some of his wisdom. Now, summarizing his quotes is really hard because every word in his book is just beautifully written, his sentences, his paragraphs. I was really blown away how beautifully they're written. So this video will also have a lot of quotes from many of his essays and books. As young Jewish adults, we're carrying a heavy load that is our heritage. And do we view it as heavy baggage that's bringing us down? Or like Rabbi Sacks makes us feel, which is it's luggage filled with wisdom and thoughts carefully picked for us from the previous generations to help us on this journey that we have of life. He wrote, "Never be embarrassed about being a Jew. Our people have survived so long and contributed so much that you should see being Jewish as an honor and a responsibility." Specifically, he has two incredible quotes. One quote is about Jewish law, which has a lot of details that could sometimes seem a bit tedious. "Never be impatient with the details of Jewish life. God lives in the details. Judaism is about the poetry of the ordinary, the things we would otherwise take for granted. Jewish law is the sacred choreography of everyday life." And when it comes to prayer, he says, "When you daven, pray, reflect carefully on the meaning of the words. Remember too that in davening, we are part of a 4,000-year-old choral symphony made up of the voices of all the Jews of all the countries in all the centuries who said these words. Some said these prayers in the midst of suffering, others as they faced exile and expulsion. They are words sanctified by tears, but we are saying them in the midst of freedom. The prayers of our ancestors have come true for us. Without them, we would not today be Jews. And without us carrying on their tradition, their hopes would have been in vain." The next point is a Judaism engaged with the world. Rabbi Sacks really believed in engaging with the wider culture of our age. And he believed that faith is enhanced, not compromised, by a willingness to honestly confront intellectual challenges. Jews, he said, never closed themselves off from other cultures, and we always appreciated scholars and righteous people from other nations. We even have a blessing that we say for scholars from all nations. But at the same time, we know that we're born into and are part of a unique heritage that we have to guard. And he really lived by this. He himself engaged and dialogued with many other religious personnel and philosophers and scientists. He always respected their faith, but at the same time showing them that Judaism has an infinite wisdom that they just can't miss on. When it comes to dealing and relationships within Jewish denominations, during his time as chief rabbi, it wasn't always so easy to deal with these different groups. Him being an Orthodox, more modern rabbi, on one end, there's the conservative and reform groups, and at the other end, there's the ultra-Orthodox that also can sometimes have maybe disagreements with him. In his book, One People, he talks about this. Are we one people? And he calls it inclusiveness, inclusive Orthodox. On one hand, Judaism, he says, is not pluralistic. He says, it cannot accept the validity of Reform and conservative Judaism as alternate readings of the Torah. So on one hand, we cannot accept the way they are interpreting the Torah, but on the other hand, it insists that these Jews are part of the covenant, participants in Judaism's bond of collective responsibility. So while we don't agree with their ideas or the validity of their movements necessarily, we accept them as people and we try to include them as much as possible. So I'd like to end this video with a few very special quotes that I love. You can find on the internet. He has dozens and hundreds of beautiful quotes. I chose a few that I really enjoyed. The first one is about asking questions. We want our kids to ask questions and be curious. And he said, "The greatest nachas for a Jewish parent is not when the teacher calls up and says, 'Your son or daughter gave a great answer today.' but rather they asked a great question in class. We want our kids to be curious and ask questions, and this is a huge part of Judaism and Leil HaSeder, and we're always looking and wanting our kids to ask questions. The second one was a comment he had on Modei Ani. The first prayer we say in the morning is we're thanking Hashem, we're thanking God for another day. And Rabbi Sacks said, we thank before we think. And this is quite interesting because Descartes is known as saying, I think, therefore I am. So it's interesting that here Rabbi Sacks says, I thank before I think. Thanking is and gratitude is a huge part of being a Jew. One of his favorite sayings was, Yiddishkeit demands Menschlichkeit. And what this means is that to be a Jew, to be a good Jew, you have to adhere to the highest standards of being a good person. And those who knew Rabbi Sacks really said that he really had the highest standards of being a mensch and being a Jew. And the last quote for this video is one from his amazing letter, Why I Am a Jew. I highly recommend you read it. There's also a video on YouTube that reads it. And he says there, I want to say to Jews around the world,
take it, cherish it, learn to understand and to love it. Carry it, and it will carry you. And may you, in turn, pass it on to future generations. For you are a member of an eternal people, a letter in their scroll. Let their eternity live on in you.
Let their eternity live on in you. So I am so grateful to Rabbi Sacks, Zichrono Livracha, may his memory be blessed, with all his amazing books, teachings and wisdom, and I hope that we can continue his rich legacy and be proud to be Jews and be mensches and learn and not be afraid to interact with the outer culture and world while remaining faithful to our wisdom and rich Jewish heritage. Hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up. See you next time.